So my last video stretched a lot, so now I'm continuing with the same place. The Muslim League also had reservation of the cabinet mission plan for it did not accept the demand of the independent country for Muslims. However, as a proposed group of the provinces were in line with what was demanded in Pakistan resolution and thus could provide a foundation for the creation of Pakistan. Qaid-e Azam accepted the plan and asked the Viceroy and the cabinet mission to enforce it completely, but the British government was not willing to do so without the consent of the Congress. So this is all about the cabinet mission, that what was the cabinet mission, what was the main points of cabinet mission and why it was rejected and by the Congress. So now we will moving to our next topic, and our next topic is interim government 1946 to 47. It was decided by the cabinet mission that only that party shall be asked to form interim government which would accept all the proposal of the mission. In fact, the mission expected that the Muslim League would turn down the proposal because of our demand of creation of Pakistan, but was not accepted. But here the story was different. The Congress did not agree to accept all the proposals of the mission. In principle, the Viceroy was obliged to invite the Muslim League to form the interim government, but this did not happen. The British government backed away from its promises because of the fear of the Congress. The Viceroy, ignoring the cabinet mission proposal, did not invite the Muslim League to form the interim government exclusively. Rather, he invited both the Congress and Muslim League to form a coalition government, and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was appointed as the vice president. Initially, the Muslim League refused to join the government because she was disappointed and displeased with the government of her backing away from the promises. The Viceroy wrote Qaid-e Azam to nominate his 5 representatives. The Muslim League remembered the unfair conduct of Congress ministers in the past. She reconsidered her decision of non-participation in the interim government and sent the names of its 5 representatives. The nominees were Liaquat Ali Khan, Sardar Abdurrahab Nishtar, Joginder Nath Mandal, Ibrahim Ismail and Raja Ghazanfar Ali Khan. The nomination of Joginder Nath Mandal, a low caste Hindu, by the Muslim League proved that the Muslim League was that also represented other communities beside the Muslims. Now, failure of the interim government, that what was in this we will study what were the reason that why interim government got failed. So here are some reasons. On September 9, 1946, the session of the Legislative Assembly was held. The Congress intended to form a constitution for the United India on account of its numerical superiority, whereas the Muslim League wished to have a separate constitution for a separate country. Thus, the Muslim League declined to attend the assembly session. On account of non-cooperation in forming constitution, the Congress demanded from the government to expel the Muslim League's ministers. During the interim government, another conflict arose between the Muslim League and the Congress when Liaquat Ali Khan presented the poor man's budget. In that budget, those taxes were withdrawn which directly affected the masses, and those were levied which affected only the rich. The Congress agitated over the budget, as most of the Hindus, capitalists and industrialists supported the Congress. So that because of this issue, as well as some others tiny issues, the interim government got failed. So today we study about the failure of interim government as well as the interim government from 1946 to 47. In my next video, I will explain you about 3rd June plan as well as the reaction of 3rd June plan, that what was the reaction upon 3rd June plan. So till my next video, stay at home, stay safe, save lives. Thank you very much.